Everybody, it's Invicta, and it is time for the Tainted Sinvicta run you all have been waiting for. Thank you very much for the positive feedback on the Sinvicta mod here on Saturday. I really do appreciate it, and I gotta say that I really loved everyone's reaction, including my own, actually, to the Sinvicta mod. So again, shout out to the White Rabbit X on the Sinvicta subreddit for making this incredible mod. And again, if you want to see more of the Sinvicta character, people have been saying that they want to see Sinvicta Saturdays or something like that. So we'll think about it, definitely, for sure. And of course, the feedback to this video is going to help drive that. So again, if you want to see something like that, let me know in the comments down below. Also, by clicking the like button, that is the best way to let me know that you want to see more of this character. And again, one final time, shout out to the White Rabbit X on Sinvicta subreddit for the awesome mod. Here we go. Well, before we do that, here's your meme of the day, artwork of the day here, submitted by, I'm going to say, Not Threebo, also known as Credoodles on Twitter. Title of the thread was Flame Skull Guy Art Featuring Little Sissy. I love the fact, this might be one of my favorite, like, fan arts ever, because of the fact that Sissy also has a Sinvicta logo on her, and she just looks awesome. She looks ready for battle. So again, this is one of those ones you want to go check out the full resolution version on my subreddit /r/Sinvicta. Shout out to Credoodles, that's D-O-O-D-E-L-S, on Twitter for this amazing art piece. Thank you very much for that. Here we go. I don't know what the Tainted Sinvicta character has in terms of abilities and whatnot. We're just going to find out. Apparently, we also have the R key. So we do have randomized movement and randomized damage and -1 HP. Not sure what that is, so let's find out here. I'm excited. All right, see, today is going to be Mike Bravo, X-Ray Delta, Hotel Kilo, Mike, Quebec. Again, I don't know if the... Oh, my gosh, our shot speed is insane. I don't know if the seeds are going to correlate with what you have on your end in terms of, like, unlocks and whatnot. Yeah, let's not take a hit because it is Curse the Unknown. Do we always have Curse the Unknown, I wonder? Sissy! We do have Sissy. We also have an Empress card here to start off with. So, yeah. So, again, look, I love the fact that time was taken to actually show not only Sissy, but also this Sinvicta character here, even starting with Arky, where we might be, depending on how crazy this run gets, we may be due for an Omega run. Maybe. We'll see. We'll see how this one goes here. Sissy Long Legs, of course, charming everyone. She's out there. She's smiling. She's happy to be here on a Saturday. It's the weekend. I hope everyone's weekend has been going off to a great start. I've got lots of trading cards to open. We've been opening Magic the Gathering. We got Star Wars Masterwork that came out yesterday. All kinds of good stuff, man. The last couple of weeks here have been really, really fun. And it's a good time to be in the mosh pit. It's always a good time to be in the mosh pit. But specifically, these last couple of weeks have been just awesome, especially with the amount of amazing runs that we've been getting over the last couple of days, really. So maybe this one will also be a straight-up banger. Okay, so no bombs, no coins, no keys, no nothing. Just how we like it. I'm going to save the Empress card most likely for the boss, especially if it's old Dookie. Of course, Sissy does directly counter any of the bosses that have any adds that that they throw out. Just from the sheer fact that she charms everything. It's really unfortunate that we're starting on a Curse of the Unknown, because I'd love to see how much HP we have. Of course, I could also just not get hit, and then we don't have to worry about it. So, sorry, look at that, Sissy! Sissy with the absolute dunking of a lifetime! Wow! Wow! We do get Magic 8-Ball, which gives us more shot speed, which is not something I wanted, but... Little Sissy, oh my goodness, destroying Gemini. Secret Room should be, you know... And we get Raw Liver. That is a lot of HP. Now, do we actually have HP or not? I guess we'll find out, but man, Sissy with the absolute dunking of a lifetime. Oh, wow. Okay, so we actually didn't get any HP at all. Or did we? We may have gotten two black soul hearts, so I'm guessing that we cannot have red hearts as HP on Tainted Sinvicta. Or aka just Sin. Okay, so that's good to know. Did we start with a half heart and I just didn't know it? I don't recall us ever getting hit. It's a good thing I didn't go in that curse room. That's why you should always play like you have zero HP. No matter who you're playing, unless you're like unless you're playing like a static character like Isaac or someone that you know you start with 3 HP. But if it's Curse of the Unknown and you're just unsure of how much HP you have, always play like you've got no HP left to give. We get our bomb back here. We pretty much had to do that to block the way. Our tears rate is not phenomenal. It's not terrible, but it's also not phenomenal. Damage 3.39 is not too bad either. There we go. The champions taking out each other, basically. Thanks to Little Sissy. A strategic R key also might be in play here. In case we don't get a lot of HP. I saw that. Don't you ever shoot at me again. I love how angry Tainted Sinvicta is. This is me. I would love to see Tainted Sinvicta getting angrier and angrier until like the eyes start glowing. as the run goes on and we keep getting if you didn't get any damage upgrades at all, the eyes just glow red, and then eventually like if you go through like, I don't know, 8 floors with 0 damage upgrades, then like you get like a 30 damage increase because his eyes are just like glowing lasers. I think that'd be hilarious. That'd be very me. Because, you know, no damage upgrades the first couple of floors. I'm like, yeah, you know, whatever. That's a standard rigmarole of life for me and Isaac. But after a certain point, there does become a tipping point where it's like, okay, we need to get damage here. This is getting ridiculous. We're not there yet. Toxic Shock. I am a big fan of Toxic Shock. I am going to blow up the donation machine here because we're going to need all the HP we can. This Lover's Card is not particularly useful. Half price sack is actually a pretty good buy here, yeah, especially with 2 keys and a bomb. I've been looking for those half price sacks a lot more often lately. The value is just there. I mean, it's just so good if you can actually get a good payout from them. Look for the secret room. It might be here. No. Well, now I just don't even know. Yeah, I should have known it wouldn't here, because if I had come down here and seen, I would have seen. Yep. If I had come down here and seen, I would have seen. Okay, we get our bomb back at least and get another key. Now I'm just clearing just to clear. Not because I want the full clear certificate, by the way, which I don't know. I don't even know if Sinvicta gets. I guess we'll find out. And Sinvicta may not get it. Toxic Shock, by the way, is going to do that green cloud that you saw, and it scales off of our base damage. It's very, very good for the early game and for taking down enemies that are kind of weak and kind of annoying. Okay, we get less than 3, which is just going to give us another soul heart at this point. Troll Bomb, or Tower Card, I should say. Where the heck is that? There's a secret room. I don't know. It could be above that room, I guess, as well. Super Secret Room should be the right of there. Alright. Here we go, Little Sissy. It's gonna be Black Dingle, so we gotta be careful of the speed, but he only charges once. You gotta get out of the way of the Dingle charge pretty much immediately. So again, notice how I'm using the poop piles here is kind of like a barrier, because thankfully Dingle cannot charge and break them down, and you can't shoot them either. Only I can shoot them. Yeah, now I'm going to travel to the opposite end of the room. Wherever Dingle is, we're going to the opposite, and then we're using that poop pile as the shield for us. It's the shield that guards the realm of sin. That's right. There we go. Okay, we do get a tears up, thank goodness. I think devil deals are out of the question here, just because I think that we're better off going for angel deals. It's just safer, especially with us having only soul hearts for HP. Yeah, I think that's the only way to go. So we do lose the Sinvicta face, thanks to the soap. So you gotta love the Flames, man. Like, that's the coolest thing. That's like one of the coolest things I've ever seen in Isaac. Is the animated flames for hair. This mod is just incredible. I am in love with it. The sheer amount of effort that went into this, and also the amount of TLC that went into it as well, is just it really does make my day to see this mod. It's so good. Very humbling. There you go. Toxic Shock taking down the worst of the worst. Good job, little sissy. I'll take Ghost Pepper. So this R key we can use to reset the run and start over. I mean, if you don't know what R key does, that's what it does. You basically start the run over again, but the time does not restart. So you can't go back and get, like, double boss rush unless you're just really, really moving. Double boss rush or double hush or anything like that is usually not going to be possible, because by the time that you use R key, you probably have already, like, lost at least 15 minutes or so. Again, unless you're just on just a straight up bang and run, you're not going to generally get a lot of the timed rewards twice. Pay to play was actually really, really important in the last run. I don't remember if that was on YouTube or if that was on Twitch, but we had a pay to play run that was hugely important with us having no keys. And something else I discovered was the fact that that chest, the golden chest, also only cost coins at that point if you have pay to play, which is awesome. Like, that's a change. That's one of those changes I didn't know. I think that was on YouTube. I think days have been, they all blend together, man. Like, by the time I'm done recording an Isaac episode, I either got to go stream or I got to get on with my daily routine or nightly routine in this case. And, all the Isaac runs, I'm like, did we do this? Did we do that? Wouldn't mind getting pay to play. By the way, I did notice we did not get the full clear ticket, so that must be a Sinvicta only feature, as we would have gotten the certificate of full clear. So no bombs. Really do need some bombs here. It's gonna be this red champion Mega Maw. This is not an easy fight. Yo. Goes for Ghost Pepper there. Help his little sissy, your only hope. Okay, way too much HP. Oh, we did get a certificate of full clear. Way too much HP lost there, but Red Champion Mega Maw is one of the worst bosses that you could possibly get. Yeah, losing 2-3 soul hearts there is not good. We cannot get pay to play, unfortunately. Got a half price soul heart. we were fortunate enough to get that. I could go do the boss trap room. This is starting to increasingly look like we're going to need to use the R key for a more strategic reasoning than, you know, going for Omega Run reasoning. So thankfully we did get Jesus Juice, which is a good damage upgrade for sure. But we definitely need a lot more, as you can see here. Our shot speed is definitely on point. I really wish that external information mod would just kind of fudge off right now, so I could see the left side. It, like, Curse of Darkness is already making it a little bit difficult to see on the corners, but just blocking like a whole wall of text up there is also kind of a little bit jarring. There we go. All right. So, and again, we can't really go into the curse room. I mean, we could, but I don't think it's worth the risk anyway. So we did get the certificate of full clear. We also got the Ancestor Rune for the next floor. Damage and Ghost Pepper. Those are, I mean, they're all good. We need to get some HP back, though. And Curse of the Lost.
Nice answers, Rune Loser.
Yep. If you're not convinced that the game like knows exactly what it's doing by now, I don't think you probably haven't been watching that long. It's pretty much guaranteed that if you get any kind of mapping at all, you're going to get Curse of the Lost on the next floor. That's an undeniable, immutable truth of life when it comes to playing this game. Okay, good. Undeniable truth is that even when I get Curse of Lost, we're still going to do a full clear, so don't worry about that. We'll have a second Ansa's rune to go with our current one. Get a Nemic, which is going to give us a range upgrade and also give us the bloody creep whenever we do get hit. There we go. So let's keep it moving. I'm calling it right now. We're going to get another certificate of full clear. That's going to happen. It could be world first here. You saw it first. The world's first certificate of full clear on Curse of the Lost. Yeah. Okay. I'm telling you. I've been playing this game long enough to see it happen for myself. Toxic Shock absolutely destroying this room along with the black poop. Excuse me. Okay, good. Is there a Tendon Rock in here? There's not. All right. Fair enough. Again, not going to go in the curse room. We just simply, it's just never worth it. If we had Voodoo Head, like, I'd consider it, but even then, like, we've already kind of talked about Voodoo Head, how it doesn't seem like it improves it all that much. We're getting some Yaves. We don't have to use a bomb here if we have a Ghost Pepper. It just needs to proc and we'll burn the Keeper. All right. So get ready for the Grandpa Head. You know it's coming. Get ready for our full clear. You ready for our certificate of full clear and the grandpa head? Told you. I mean, you laugh at me. You think I'm joking. I've seen it way too often. Certificate of full clear, world first. eBay one of one, alpha parallel, unique situation. Certificate of full clear on Curse of the Lost. A called shot, Curse of the Lost, as well. All right, now let the prophecy commence. Give us our grandpa head, and we will be on our way. Oh, it's coming.
Grandpa! Oh! Grandpa, look! Oh!
I mean, I'm telling you, you can't say I didn't call that. Well, I mean, you haven't been watching enough. If you don't know that I can't predict these things. LOL. All right. Floor 5 devil deal. Or angel deal. Here we go. Super pride. Super dead. 9 lives. 9 lives is a tough sell here. I think we're still going to take it, but we need to make sure that we have a way of getting our soul hearts back first. So, depending on what we see in this curse room here. Okay, I'm going to leave that there. The Mega Troll Bomb, just kind of curve and give us that. Ah, I didn't want to take that. Oh, baby. Well, that's a very apt, maybe even poor choice of wording there, but we get C-section. So C-section does some interesting things here for us. I think what we have to do is we have to go fight the boss first and then double back. Well, no. We need to get 9 lives before we fight the boss, because we're going to get an angel deal on this floor. Well, theoretically anyway. And if that's the case, then what happens is that there's probably a good possibility we're going to find eternal hearts or soul hearts in there. And we want to take the soul hearts on 9 lives. Our tears rate needs to improve drastically, though, for C-section to really be effective. Oh my goodness. Well, there's quad shot. We need to do everything we can to get quad shot. We're only gonna have one roll here so far. One hope. Quad shot and C-section would be a very, very good build for us. Okay, so I think we go back and we go get 9 lives. We get 9 lives, go grab the soul hearts that we did not pick up, or soul heart, I guess I should say, that we didn't pick up. Oh no, it didn't take away the HP. Okay, never mind. Why did it not take away the HP? I thought it should have. It might only take the red heart HP away from you, but this is a soul heart only character, so... I'm not sure. I'm gonna use the Hermit card here. I was hoping that we got some money for that. We really, 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 really want quad shot here. Another certificate of full clear, as to be expected. I don't know how we did that though, because we've seen the rest of the map. Maybe it's because of the Ansa's rune. But we need to go back, and hopefully there's some money and bombs on the way to the super secret room. It's funny, game. Okay. Okay, so we have basically one more chance to get quad shot here. We can try to use... Oh man, this is going to take a while. Okay. Come on, third time's a charm here. We got one luck. Oh! He's done it. Quad shot C-section. Let's go. All right, use the Ansa's rune again here. We can go into the vault. Oh my god, our tears rate. I mean, you knew it was going to happen, but it's still worth it, in my opinion, to let loose four C-sections instead of one. Because we weren't firing that much with one, you know, at that time. So I think it's still worth it. And we have a really good base to build a solid build out of here. Okay, we get Kid's Drawing, which is a Guppy item. Guppy would be nice, but if we can get some HP first, that'd also be nice. That's good stuff. C-section plus plus toxic shock is gonna make this happen here. Now I would certainly not be opposed to getting something like almond milk, soy milk, something like that to increase our tears rate for sure. Game Kid. Again, we're not gonna get rid of the R key until we have to use it. Essentially. I think just taking another soul heart here is going to be wise. We don't have D-Bizzle, so that room doesn't really matter. And we're looking for the Tinted Skull. Well, do we have to? I don't think we actually have to get out of this floor. We've already gone to everywhere. We just haven't been to the secret room, which is right meow. Okay. We can afford to go into the cursed room as well. And we get Guppy's Paw! Okay, so that plus the Kid's Drawing will become Guppy for us. But we have to hold on to a Kid's Drawing. There we go. Oh, Flaming Guppy, look at that. Yo, that looks sick. Look at this Invicta Guppy. Oh my gosh, that looks so cool, man. There's our certificate of full clear again. We'll get ourselves another Ansa's rune. Dude, that is awesome. Now, if you want to draw some art, draw some of that right there. That looks amazing. Yeah, so we're not going to need the full card. There we go. So C-section Guppy. What happens with the Mulligan effect is that as long as the babies are swarming and dealing contact damage with something, they will produce the Mulligan flies. We get Swarm Protector. That's just super great. That's just really, really good. It's just real great. I will take Swarm Protector only for the, basically only for the Eternal Heart generation possibilities. We'll head on Dizown. All right, we got Curse the Unknown again, but that's okay. So I think we only need to go for the full clear certificate. I think we only need to go to all adjacent rooms, to every single room on the map. We don't actually have to physically go into all rooms. We just have to see them all. I think that's how that works. So, like, us going up into this room that we're in currently is enough for us to cover all three of the rooms around us. Latch key, which is going to give us a leg upgrade. I cannot get away from this Mega Troll Bomb. Oh, yeah, this is the good stuff here. This is the good stuff right here. Now we're talking Omega Run possibility. It's a good Saturday. Watch me another R key in here or something. Give me greed. Wouldn't mind a Steam sale. A cardio coin. So sorry. That'd be great if Sissy could pick up stuff for you too. But not in like a bum friend bumbo way, in like an actual like good way. Check out the curse room. Isaac apparently stuck out his little baby toe on that one. So guardian or swarm protector will act as an orbital and give you a chance to get an eternal heart for one out of every 10 shots that it blocks. Something like that. Double bomb payout. I'll take that as well. Here we go, Sissy. Would have loved to have gotten that PhD as well. Seeing a lot of bombs show up lately, or a lot of pills show up, I should say. Yeah, look at the C-section baby. They're just waiting. Swarm them. Yeah, there you go. All four of them get on them. All right, we are going to get a good tears up here. Well, not a good one, but we did get a tears up. Cambion Conception, Dark Matter. I mean, Dark Matter gives us more damage for sure, but that would also take one of our lives, and I don't really want to do that. We didn't get a full clear certificate that time, now that I think about it. I was like, wait a second, we missed something. Okay, so maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. Maybe you do have to go into almost like 90% of the full of the map or all of it. I don't know, man. Whatever was over there blew up in a hurry. Wow, we went straight to Mom's heart. And who's to blame? There we go. C-section is a pretty big counter to Mom's heart. We do get our angel deal, so that's kind of another reason why I didn't want to get... I did not want to take Dark Matter, so I didn't want the devil deal precedent. There we go. Get the key piece. Oh, baby. We're rocking and rolling. Not going to fight Hush right now. If we end up getting him on the way back with the Polaroid, then I definitely will. We're on Shoal. We're in Shoal, let's put it that way. There you go, Toxic Shock. Again, the higher that our base damage goes up, the more damage the Toxic Shock is going to do. And the safer that we're ultimately going to be. Okay. Are you a wizard horse pill? Doesn't really matter for C-section that much, because obviously they have super homing on them. But the horse pill is going to... I mean, we're essentially going to be wizarded for the next, like, 2 minutes or something like that. Mr. Boom, hey, we got an Eternal Heart, which I didn't pick up. Also, people in the comment section were saying that there's also a hidden property or hidden trait of Sinvicta, where it's called Curse of the Memory or something, and that's what was causing stuff to disappear in the shop. I didn't even notice it because obviously, I mean, like I unironically did not even notice that happening until that soul heart disappeared, that one time. Stars card. Okay. We can use that in the dark chest. That is a little bit of the unfortunate, like, that's a little bit of a downside to the C-section build that we currently got, is the fact that the babies have to, let's call them tears, let's stop calling them babies. The tears have to actually land relatively on top of the target that I'm trying to kill, for them to do their contact damage and give us the guppy flies and stuff. So in other words, we have to pretty much stay at full range here. Swarm Protector, great block there. Two of the projectiles got taken out. It was like that was a weird delay on that foot not coming down up top in this right here. I was expecting for it to come down here, so that was odd. Very odd exchange, but you just see how fast and how easy C-section just destroys endgame bosses, even with like not really great damage. Guppy's Collar would give us the freedom to get rid of the child's drawing, child's portrait. So I am gonna do that. And we're on half heart. I mean, half heart doesn't really matter. We could take Heartbreak as well, but then that would, if we continually die over and over again, I'll take Gimpy as well. Okay, that was not Guppy's Collar. That was nine lives at Resnus. Oh my goodness, we went far away here. Sack Dagger. What a do. Now the only question is with the stars card is where do we need to go from here? Well, not in that direction, I can tell you that. So we're hoping that we get some good chests here as well to show up. I could have taken, it is true, I could have taken Guppy's Collar first. Well, no, that actually is not true. I take that back. I was going to say I could have taken Guppy's Collar first without having to die and then taken the mark, and then we would have preserved those lives, but we only had three soul hearts to begin with. So that actually was not possible, not doable. I mean, Sprinkler is not bad with C-section, but yeah, Arky though. Okay, so all we gotta do is just no hit lamb, no problem. Look at that, C-section is just so good, man. So good. You know we're gonna do a victory lap. You know it. Second seed, 7 Bravo, Victor Hotel, Victor Delta, Tango Kilo. Round 2, we're ready for it. Little sissy. All right, so the plan here is to hopefully, find ourselves either Diplopia or what we really want is School Bag. Excuse me. If we can find School Bag, then basically we've got a real shot at getting Omega Run. I mean, we'll go for it. Don't get me wrong. Like, we'll definitely try. I think this run has potential. Candy Heart's not going to give us basically anything. I wouldn't mind getting the full clue. That's another thing that's nice about about this Invicta character. The certificate of full clear is nice because you get those guaranteed Ansa's runes, which just help you just get another one after that. So. Could take golden pills here. If we still had PH Dizzle, or if we had PH Dizzle, I should say, definitely be more inclined to. Secret Room should definitely be here. That's about the only place it could be. All right. Gumby Gurglings. So the plan for this lap, I think what we need to do, we do get a tears up and an HP upgrade as well. I think what we need to do for this lap here is to probably force a shot at Delirium, which would require us to go through the Angel Deals anyway. So, and this is the problem that you have when you try to go for Omega runs. Now, again, obviously this game is not designed for Omega runs. If you don't know what Omega runs are, by the way, for those of you who have not seen me do one, essentially it means all bosses are killed on the same run without interruption. So that means we go through every single boss, every single optional boss, et cetera, up through Delirium and Hush. And then after that, we go fight Mother through Alt Path and everything like that. And then we end it with Beast because there's no coming back when you do the Ascent. So, but the problem is that we have to go through Mega Satan. Now, Mega Satan it's either going to end the run, it just ends the run for some odd reason, or what will happen is it will actually give you a Delirium Portal. It's 50-50. I don't know the exact percentage on that, but that is always something, that's always a risk that we have to go through when we are attempting to go for an Omega run. No matter what, we have to go through that. So if we get past that point, then the Omega run becomes a real possibility. Get Seraphim here, and I am going to bomb. We get the Seraphim transformation actually as well. This is our second key piece, which is good. So we are not going to go down through the, we're not going to go through Downpour right now. We're going to save that for the next run, for the next lap, I should say. We also did not get our Certificate of Full Clear, by the way, which I don't know if the Certificate of Full Clear procs off of a certain number of rooms or if it's, I'm not sure. Wow, we get a lot of HP in here as well. Lots of spiders, little sissy. Sissy, you almost blocked that hard. I didn't even see it there. What are you doing, girl? We get a planetarium. And we get Mercurius. Oh, baby. Get a Joker card anyway, along with our Certificate of Full Clear. The world. So I think what we do is we take the Joker card for sure. Even though we've got Mercurius now, so Mercurius is just going to show us everything. Oh, you know why we didn't get one? I think it's because we didn't go into the curse, or we didn't see the secret room. Maybe. So Mercurius is definitely going to speed things up. If we can get some kind of mapping as well, I realize that I'm saying that with leaving the answers room there. But Mercurius is going to make all the doors stay open for us, and we can just fly through things. Omega run possibility. Now, in order for us to actually get credit for clearing the rooms, however, we obviously still have to clear the rooms. Just because we can fly through the doors does not mean that we get a free pass for, like, you know. It's like, okay, we clear this room, we clear that room. But with Toxic Shock, and if our base damage does get high enough, we will be able to just fly through them. And then Toxic Shock takes care of everything. Didn't even see what hit us there. The ladder we don't need. I will take out the Keepa. So this lap will be our Mega Stand lap here. So we're gonna go up through Normal Path to go fight Isaac, to go fight Blue Baby. Then we'll fight Mega Satan. We can also get Boss Rush and Hush out of the way on this run here. This run right here. Get another tiers up. Thank goodness for that. Two attacks per second now. With Quad Shot, we are going to get hard capped at a certain amount. I don't know what that cap is. With C-section, it might be 2.5 attacks per second. And basically what I'm doing here is I'm just looking for more, just perusing around. It's almost inconsequential for us with Mercurius to just go run through the entire level. That way we do get the Answers Rune and we can use the Joker card now. We get the Holy Mantle. There's no need for us to go into, there's no need for us to fight the Angel Statue because obviously we already have our two key pieces. And we have our Answers Rune for the next floor, which again is going to increase the speed at which we can just fly through the next level. We're not really in a hurry, but if we're going for an Omega run, these are going to take a while. So I'd like to cut it down a little bit and save my voice a little bit. Yeah, so we would have had to have used the Joker card anyway on here, which is good. So Ansa's Rune. Now, another possibility is that we can go through Alt Path and get the mother. It is possible if we get a teleportation card, we go down to Corpse 2 and we get a teleportation card out. Assuming there's a sacrifice room, we can do an Omega run that way as well. It's a little bit more challenging, but that is a possibility. We maintain Guppy here because obviously we have the three Guppy items no matter what. It's a simple process of, you know, we don't have to, we're no longer limited by needing to keep the child's drawing on us as a third Guppy item. We can take that. It's actually pretty good that we have that Joker card because now we also have an increased chance of getting another Angel Deal on this floor here. And if we can get just a little bit more damage out of this build here, like we end up getting something like a Godhead Sacred Heart, oh man, we're sitting real pretty, real real pretty. As we go through this room here. Oh, apparently we weren't done here. Needle. We got this sissy. Oh man, I'm excited. Hey. Blessed Penny is going to give us a chance of getting a soul heart, half soul heart for us every time we pick up a coin. There's a champion needle in here. And there's our certificate of full clear. We get friend finder as well. But unfortunately, again, we... Thank you, Curse the Memory. Unfortunately, we can't take that yet because we still have the Archie. It basically just comes down to this. It just comes down to us passing the Mega Stamp portal. Now, the other possibility here is that if we get a teleport, it's a little bit of a wonky... Well, we got a Devil Deal instead of an Angel Deal. Money Equals Power is a lot of damage, but we need tears. And I'm still more interested in getting an Angel Deal. There we go. Okay, so I think we roll hard here for school bag, although this isn't an ideal shop. Car battery, sack head, alabaster box. I mean, the alabaster box is definitely a possibility. Oh, that was keeper sack. It's definitely a possibility with us having Blessed Penny, but again, it's not something that we need to use here. It would have given us two Angel Deal items, but we have no way of holding onto our Archie, and that's really what the problem comes down to. We get Dead Bird. Champion of the people. I love how we can just fly through things here with Holy Mantle, too. This is so nice. I want to go back. Charge key for our troubles. Excuse me. And Holy Mantle, of course, if you don't know what it does, it will give us a shield, which will prevent one hit of damage per room. Wow, Monstro went down in a hurry. Get the staple, which is going to give us more damage. And we are on the hype train here. Not a Twitch hype train, of course, but we are on the hype train. The anticipation is now, I'm getting even more excited here, sissy. Because what happens now is that we go fight Boss Rush. We have to do Boss Rush in order for us to qualify as an Omega Run. Again, these are all the arbitrary rules that I've set last year. But we do Boss Rush. We kill Mom. We do Boss Rush after we kill Mom, obviously. And then we go to the Cathedral. We go to Isaac. And beat Blue Baby as well. And then we double back and go after... go after a Mega Satan, and then that will determine whether or not this run can continue as an Omega run or not. So hopefully we don't get shut out. It'll be kind of a bummer, but if it happens, it happens. What? Apparently I cannot take that. Apparently I can't take that. All right. I think that was Redmon.
Grandpa! Oh, Grandpa, he did it all. Grandpa.
Sure. We'll take perfection, even though we probably won't hold on to it. I think the Halo is definitely a good pull here. Now, this boss rush may not be the fastest one that we're ever going to see, just because of our limited tiers rate, but... Yeah, and we are capped at 2.03, so... But luckily, when we do have the damage going out, we're doing lots of it. Here's our Holy Mantle. So I'm going to actually drop Perfection just in case. That's not Clog, by the way. That's actually Brownie. Actually, Black Brownie. We picked up Champion Belt, so we're going to see a lot of Champion bosses in here. Not all of them, but some of them. There we go. We just want... Essentially, what C-Section does is it just turns into a vessel for the Mulligan. We would have lost Perfection right there. That's some serious damage. And the crazy thing is our base damage isn't even all that high. It's just the combined nature of C-Section's tier effect and as well as our Mulligan tiers going in and just going ham. Oh, there's a Tinted Rock. I missed it. Curse of Lost. Doesn't really matter with us having Mercurius. If we just run into a dead end, we just simply walk out. That's it. I want this Tinted Rock. I'm mad that I missed that last one. There's usually always one inside the mom room fight. We can go into the curse rooms because again we have Holy Mantle, so no real big deal. I mean, Sissy's kind of a big deal. We all know that. She's the biggest of deals. Get the virus. It's 2 of 3 for Spun. Secret room should be here. World card. Unfortunately, it doesn't really help us here with Curse of the Lost. There we go. Whew. Yeah, Salvation does indeed proc the Guppy effect. And we also just get Immaculate Heart, which is going to give us even more damage. And I think that's also going to help us with the shot trajectory of our C-Section babies, because they're going to swirl around us, essentially. That's good. I think they're gonna do the swirl. Yeah. Oh no, it's just gonna be the tier. Or maybe that may have been my reflection thanks to $3 bill. I'm not entirely sure on that. The most important thing is that we got a huge increase in base damage. That's the biggest thing. So there's our Delirium Portal, but we got to go fight Hush first. Old Hushy. We got to go to Old Hushy first just because of the nature. So far, it's looking like we're only going to get one luck. Or we're only going to get one. Ooh, it hurts. It's going to be good. We're only going to get one chance at an R key. There we go. That's the good stuff. Sissy, you can take this one. You can take the rest of the day off if you want to. We got this. We got Eye of Belial actually proccing now from $3 bill. We also had an increased tiers right there. I think that may have been number one for a second. Oh my goodness. What on earth are those shots? Okay. Do we have Spider Babby or something? We got Quad Shot. We got Sissy. He was just spinning out just spiders. Oh gosh, listen to the holy beams. Old Hushy, no it, Old Hushy. Wow, those crack the sky beams from Holy Light. Good Lord, man. Those are brutal. And I don't even feel bad for it. Black Death. Black Death looks really, really freaking cool. Really, all the black champions look like amazing. Black Widow also looks really good. All right, well, here's the test. Will we or will we not get a Delirium Portal? Curse the Blind. There's the Mega Stand door. We have to get past this. If we don't get past it, then carrying on with the Omega Run just doesn't even matter. As you see here with Mercurius, we're able to walk through. And there's Black Widow. Mega Maw as well. So if we get a, if we get to the Delirium Portal here, we could find either hopefully a Telepills, or we could find a like a Fool Card. Really, any way to get out of the Mega Stand room. We didn't find one, so now that doesn't even matter. Now it comes down to us getting the Delirium Portal from Mega Satan. If that doesn't happen and we the run's just over. I really hope that Ed and Vin consider just removing that, because you think about the chances of you having to do Mega Satan as well as Delirium in one run for like unlocks and stuff. And that makes it difficult. You have a really awesome run. Like, imagine if we were on Jacob and Esau or something like that. You have this really powerful run. You want to knock out as many bosses as possible, but you can't because the Mega Satan door didn't open, the Delirium Portal. That ghost pepper completely canceled out all of the shots from Mega Satan. Oh yeah, Stanley is not long for this world. Wish we had that tears up as well. All right, give us the portal, give us the chance. He did. Let's go. Oh, baby. All right. Now all we need is either Diplopia and School Bag, or we need the Victory Lap portal for Mother. Or not Victory Lap portal. Sorry. The Victory Lap sack room in Corpse 2. If we get that and a teleportation card, we can get out and complete the prophecy. This is not Delirium. Ooh, this Invicta robes though, lots of damage. Definitely take that. How good is Mercurius as well, just allowing us to just do this. All right. But it comes down to us getting either, we need to get something like Genesis or another R key. Because now the problem becomes, how do we get out of the mother, out of the mother room? And the only way to do this is to kill Mother in Corpse 2, and then after that, we go to the sacrifice room. I've seen sacrifice rooms in Corpse 2 before, but they're rare. I think that was Explosivo. All right, down goes Delirium. Alt path, here we come. 1 hour into it, we've got an Omega Run possibility. Where's the XL? Same seed, 7 Bravo, Victor Hotel, Victor Delta Tango Kilo. And we're off. Did lose perfection, by the way. So another possibility of us getting an R key. Oh, man. Wow. Tammy's head C-section. This is going to be so good. Well, actually, you know what? Tammy's head didn't fire off the C-section babies. I thought it did. Well, there's our boss room. We still got to go find the other item room. There it is. We get 120 volt. There's our Isaac Donut. So if we get mystery gift or some kind of reroll pedestal, yeah, we can take Red Stew. That would also be ideal. We're basically just looking for a way to get an R key now at this point. The glass eye. We don't need Spirit of the Night, so I'm just going to go ahead and pass on that. Use the Ansa's rune here. So we're in downpour 2. And that's important to remember because we had an XL floor. Keep that in mind. Skin on mushroom. Not really gonna make a difference for us. There's pay to play. Not that I think we need keys. Keys are not gonna be a problem anymore anyway.
Grandpa, he did it all! Grandpa!
You go in the curse room, right? Or the secret room. Did not. Yeah, I mean, you know, a little bit of shot speed. Didn't hurt nobody. I think that was Min Min. Okay, so let's go get the... Let's go get our key. Well, our not key, but our knife piece. You'd be supremely careful in this room here, especially with us having $3 bill. We don't know when a like an explosive shot's gonna proc, so yeah. I think we just get in and get out. We really don't need to fight Wormwood again. Not because I think that we can't beat him or anything, it's just that there's no reason to. I mean, do we really need another extra item? I don't believe so. All right, we got one knife piece down, one to go. Didn't get a full clear certificate this time, which is okay. Ashpit Curse the XL. Oh man, Loki's horns plus this build here. Scapular, I will take. Now we don't have to hit the golden buttons either. They're kind of unnecessary with us having flying, but we do still need to go into the mine shaft, obviously, because we need to go get that second knife piece. I don't want to keep calling it a key piece. I mean, I guess it kind of is a key piece in a way. Hey. The mother transformation, my reflection. That's what it was. So it was a my reflection proc off of a $3 bill, which made the babies go insane like that. There it is. What the heck? Muy bueno. was a lot of not really useful items across all different item pools. Let's take it. Muy bueno. Oh, that was unexpected. The Spanish mosh pit's like, oh! Oh, that's so good. That's interesting that the fire on Sin's face is not animated anymore. There's our full clear certificate for some reason. It's in here, all right. Maybe it's a number of rooms that you go through. I don't know. All right, we got the knife piece. Now, what we need to start looking for is a teleportation, some kind of teleportation to get out of corpse too. If we do have a sacrifice room, this is assuming, of course, that we don't find an R key. Oh, yeah, we don't have Holy Mantle anymore. That's right. I'm not sure what we're supposed to do here. You don't actually have to get the key here. You can just throw a bomb down there and walk through the gap. There we go. Might as well check the curse room just for funsies. So what happened to my... It must have taken away my ancestor's rune because you can't leave that area without with something. I don't know. Standard HP upgrade. Now goes Singe, no problem. And we do get spun actually as well. Brimstone bombs, not what we're looking for. All right, well, we gotta find a teleport and we gotta hope that there's a sack room inside a corpse too. Curse of darkness.
Imprisoning me.
Yeah, I think there was something alive over there that is not anymore. What the heck? Just bounced off everything. Oh, good God. This is that will actually kill our fire rate. I'm gonna do it anyway. No, it didn't actually kill our fire rate. It just stayed the same. We're just gonna be firing out like two more or three more babies. Something like that. And even, I mean, more projectiles is good. Don't get me wrong. Okay. Good speedball. Might as well take it. And we get the Eucharist, which is gonna give us a guaranteed angel deal no matter what. Whew. A lot of damage, sissy. We don't need to go to the shop unless we think the mystery gift is going to be in there. Could be here. It's not. Weird, it wasn't letting me use Tammy's head for some reason. I guess we may have been free. We may have been feared by those masks. Cubby's tail, sure. Yeah, we don't have to worry about keys anymore for chests because we've got pay to play. Humbling Bundada. Was kind of hoping for the mystery gift so we can at least spawn something inside of the cursed room. There's our full clear certificate, and we got our Ansa's room for the next floor. Guess I should check the mob trap room. I don't think this can spawn our key. No. Well, you know what? I don't even care. Pop the Ansa's rune here. The Eye of Guppy, or Guppy's Eye. So now what we're really hoping for is we got to find a teleport card, which so I am going to buy some stuff out of the store. And I think that it's going to come down to us getting a sacrifice room in Corpse 2. Or it can be a Greek fight. Rock over there. Actually, I haven't seen Small Rock at all in this run, which is a little bit surprising. I was drawing again. Lover's card. It's not a teleport, unfortunately. Oh, there. Hey, there. Whoa, there. Reroll for something amazing. Of course, we don't know what the blind item is, but it's Bozo. Fast bombs, shielded tears. I don't know if tractor beam even makes sense here. I'm pretty sure that it doesn't. Yeah, it didn't matter. Okay, that's what I thought. We get 9 lives. We don't need 9 lives again. We got plenty of lives here. Isaac. All right, and here comes the mom fight. There she goes. There goes my mama. Watch her as she goes. Angelic Prism. That's going to be a lot more C-section. We get Baby Bender, which we don't need. Yeah. Mom's heart. Down it goes. And we're running out of space here. We have to hope for a sacrifice room in Corpse 2, otherwise it's over. Curse of Blind doesn't matter. It no longer matters for anything here. It just comes down to us getting a sacrifice room inside of Corpse 2. Because then the teleport doesn't even matter anymore. And in fact, I can actually guarantee that we can get out of this. So we don't even need the teleport card because we have 9 lives. Isaac can just off himself. Oh man. Ooh, we get revelation, okay. Yeah, so Isaac can just yeet himself out of here. And that would be it. And then we would get removed from the mother fight, I should say, without us having to teleport, although it would still be better for us to teleport because, you know, we're not going to have enough HP to. Oh. I held my breath for a second. I was like, it would have been perfect had that been an R key, but it wasn't meant to be. So give us a sac room. We want a sacrifice room here in Corpse. Otherwise it is definitively over. And we will not get the Omega run, but we gave it our college try. We get a sacrifice room here in Corpse 2, and then we go fight Beastie, and that's it. That's the Omega run complete. Yeah, well, there's the mother fight. So this is the end of the line here, unless if we end up getting a sacrifice room. We got a sacrifice room. Oh my goodness. And that is not a teleportation card, unfortunately, but we got the sacrifice room and there's HP to boot. If we could just get a teleport, we wouldn't have to worry about wasting all of our HP for Isaac to off himself. No, we need the Degas rune. Okay, so we need to beat Mother. And then we're gonna have to lose. We have enough HP here, but I'm gonna actually. Oh, you know, no. You know what we need to do? We need to use the HP now. There's no reason to waste it beforehand. Let's use the HP now, while we still have HP, because we're not gonna die to Mother. So let's get this down to all the way to the proper payout. To get teleported for the victory lap. And then go fight Mother, and then we've already paid it. Yeah, this is over. We got it. Oh, baby. Look at that. We're getting some HP back as well. We get the wafer. Oh, man. Oh, it's perfect, sissy. Oh, we get Crown of Light as well. Okay, so Uriel is next. Whoa there, Angelic Prism. Okay, next is Gabriel. Okay, we're good. We Gucci. Now all we got to do is, we can go down to one heart here against Mother. Get the mark anyway. I'm going to leave that there. I'm going to purposely just lose a bunch of HP here. Oh my gosh. She may actually die before we can even deal enough damage to ourselves. Pulling invincibility is just owning this, yeah. Down goes Mother. We gotta bomb ourselves out. The job's not done yet. This is gonna take a while with us having the wafer, actually, but it's gonna be worth it. It's gonna require another 6 bombs in order for us to get out of here. And what's going to happen is we're going to resurrect outside of this room and get taken to the previous room. Man, I'm glad that I thought about playing that pre-playing that sacrifice room before coming down here. That would have been a real Sinvicta boneheaded play there. Okay, well, Scapular. Thank you, Scapular. I appreciate your enthusiasm for being here, but this is the one time we don't need you to do that. Look at all these soul hearts we're getting from Gimpy, too. right, the next bomb should be able to take us out of here. And we're out. Now all we got to do is get teleported to the lamb, and then victory lap is ours. We get the Leviathan transformation in case we needed the HP anyway. I'm going to use the disguise rune just to give us even more soul hearts. Excuse me. Let's go grab this one over here too. Might as well. Okay, never mind. Curse the memory is taking all of our soul hearts away. There we go. So we gotta fight. We gotta fight Lamb one more time. Abba dabba ding dong, mom's knife. Abba dabba ding dong, I don't think is gonna really do anything for us, to be honest. So we're just looking for Lamb now. Oh yeah. Thank goodness for Mercurius as well. Here we go. Victory lap is upon us. One more time for the Tainted Sinvicta Omega run. The final seed, Golf Charlie 8, Golf Tango Papa Yankee Zulu. We got Hushy, we got Delirium, we got Mother, we got it all. We're ending with Beast. Blue Baby, Isaac is gone. We got, and Sissy was here too. Little Sissy was here for it all. We didn't really have to bomb our way in here, but you know what? We're gonna do it anyway. Little Sissy. I think this might be her first Omega run. It may be. This also might be our fastest Omega run as well. Get a planetarium here. And it's going to be Neptunus. I don't know how that works with C-section, actually. I don't think it does. Yeah, it doesn't. Astral projection. I mean, why not at this point? Why not, man? We're just having fun. Oh, my goodness. I don't know what that was. I'm actually not going to take the stopwatch. Get a soul heart there. Might as well go take that. Okay. Got to remember Curse of the Memory. I mean, come on. We also got Muy Bueno. What more could you want? Really? I can't believe that we got that sacrifice room in Corpse 2. That was so clutch. I told you, it's rare to see, but it is possible to see them. And really, the only time that you would even care about something like that would be when you're going for an Omega run. Get our Angel Deal and get Vade Retro, which doesn't really matter. Apparently, Sin cannot pick up Eternal Hearts. I'm not sure what's up with that. We really don't even have to go get these items because we're going to get them on the way back through the ascent. So for those of you upset I'm skipping these item rooms, we literally will be getting them back. So never you fear. Don't worry your pretty little heads. Your boy's got you covered. Get meat. There's a little bit more damage here. Another swarm protector. Sure, why not at this point? We almost have conjoined just purely based on swarm protectors. Yeah, again, we don't care. We'll come back on the way. Also opens up another possibility of another planetarium. Not that there's anything that we really want or need out of there. I mean, Mercurius would probably actually be it. I know we got Luckfoot, but like our tiers up are tier stats already capped? That's the only one that you really gun for when you're taking, or at least I really gun for whenever I'm taking pills anyway. We got Luckfoot a long time ago, and that would at least prevent us from getting negative pill effects. Another Halo here. Take another magic 8-ball. And here we are. We don't even need to do this level. We're just going to go straight for old Beastie. Mausoleum. The final store here has got nothing in it. All right. Did the music change for this? I don't remember hearing this music ever. This is like a new track to me. Something's different about this. I don't know if that's I'm not sure if that's an audio glitch or if there's something different going on here. Dad's note did not spawn. So that might be a bug I have to report to Vin. Because Dad's note should have spawned here. I'm gonna have to give myself Dad's note via the console. That's the only, because we're softlocked right now. We've run across this one other time, I think, when we were going for an Omega run. So yeah, we have to force that.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
A little unfortunate, but that's Isaac, baby. Sure. Take the body. For some reason, there's no music now. There we go. I had to unmute it and remute it. Hey, Mini Mush. Got the fungi transformation. We got all kinds of transformations here. So yeah, I will report that to Ed and Vin. I have a feeling that the R key is probably what's screwing that up. I could be wrong about that. But again, the game wasn't designed for us to go for Omega Run, so it's like, yeah. Is that Linger Bean or is that Mega Bean? Linger Bean. But oh baby. Had it spawned properly, we would have had our Omega Run. I mean, it still doesn't really detract away from the Omega Run regardless. Okay, Relic. You know, luckily the console is there to prevent us from getting softlocked like that. Oh man, our first Omega Run in a long time. I don't know if this... Is this the first Omega Run of 2022? I think it might be. Kidney Bean, no thank you. Explosivo, eh. No. Oh! That was soy milk. The soy milk was there. We had it there, sissy. Hook, line, and sinker. Soy milk would have greatly increased our tiers right there. We did get rubber cement though, which is not bad for Revelation. I don't know if it, oh my God. I don't know if it helps out with C-section at all. I mean, they kind of bounce all over the place anyway. Quick, just so we go up to full HP. Not that we need it, of course. We're in victory formation. We're going for our Omega run. It's so crazy that it takes us like we're an hour and 30, almost 31 minutes into this video. 1 hour, 30 minutes and 52 seconds. We've had regular Eden runs go longer on one singular run than this run has had for an entire Omega run. That's insane to think about. So the Omega run is upon us and we have got it done. Now, of course, this doesn't mean that every time you play this character, for those of you playing along at home, will have a chance to do an Omega. I mean, I guess everyone has a chance to do an Omega run, but that's not guaranteed, obviously, if you end up playing Sin. But hey, it's a good way to practice Omega runs if you want to do so yourself. Check the link down below for the download. And again, thank you to the White Rabbit X for making this incredible mod. I cannot think of a more awesome way to celebrate the tainted Sinvicta character here on a Saturday, no less. What an amazing run. If this one doesn't get you to hit that like button, I don't know what will, because you talk about dominance. We got Sissy, we got everything. We got Omega run. It's literally everything. Oh, it's so great. So great. Down goes War. They're not even getting any attacks off. Death is already dead. And here comes old Beastie. So, wow, what a run. What a run, man. C-section going ham right now. I got a fire up. Oh, it skipped it. Woo, the Omega run is complete. We did get soft locked there, but who cares about that? We got it anyway. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, if you enjoyed what you saw, make sure you click that like button. It takes less than a second, and it helps out my channel so much. Leave me a comment down below. Have you ever completed an Omega run? I would love to know. And of course, thank you one final time to the White Rabbit X for making this awesome video. Hope you had a great start to your Saturday, everyone. That's one good start of a new weekend, I gotta say. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Min Nguyen, Bart Mayuswin, Tybit Heagle, Rake409, Ben Ramsey, and Cody the Wolf. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.